Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. I also have a podcast where each week I cover another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D. Hi everyone, I hope you had a great New Year's. It's crazy that this podcast has been going for an entire year. This is the 52nd episode, and there are 52 weeks within a year. So that's really exciting, and I appreciate all of you that have stayed around for the entire journey of this podcast and have been 3D modeling along with me. Today's tool that we're going to be going over is the Flatten Tool, and I actually used this recently, so I wanted to show you where I used it. I started 3D modeling this creature. It's a combination of a lizard, a robot, and a dragon all in one. And I may rig this at some point in the future and texture it and such. If you look up here, you'll see that although this is a largely curved kind of form, we have these flat areas up here, and I used that Flatten tool that I was talking about at the beginning in order to create those surfaces so that we could have these attachments to help control the positioning of the wires that go through here, because this is a robot. And let's go through how this tool works. So I'm going to open up a new project in here. I'm going to drop in a sphere primitive by holding a click on here and choosing our sphere. I'll change our display mode to garage shading lines so that we can see our edges. Our type, I want to change to hexahedron because I like the quad formation on this type of sphere. And then I'll hit the C hotkey in order to make this editable. Now, there are three modes in which this Flatten tool works. It works in point mode, edge mode, and polygon mode. And you can select that area in any three of these modes. So I'll start off with polygon mode. You can see you have your different modes up here. And if you hover over them, you can see what they're called. I'll go over to my brush selection. I made the sphere editable using the C hotkey. You can also use this button down here. And now that I've done that, I can make selections on these modes here, polygon, edge, and point. So what I'll do is I'll select here and we'll make a few selections to show how this works. I'll hold down shift, I'll select here and add that to our selection. While holding down shift, I'll add a third area to our selection. Now we have these three areas selected and we're going to flatten them. So I'll go down to the mesh menu in order to find our mesh tools. If I go down to move, you'll see we have all these different tools for moving in here. Many of these we've already covered. Next to flatten, you'll see that there are no hotkeys listed for it, like there are for the magnet and brush tool and so on. So that means this one doesn't have a hotkey assigned to it right out of the box, but you can add one if you want to, or you can do what I like to do and add it to your interface. You can just click these buttons up here. And if you know you're going to be using a lot of these move tools pretty often, you can click here and it separates it. So now we can click on this dotted area again, and as I drag this around my UI, you can see this gray line showing up, and that just means you can drop this set of tools here. So I'll put it off to the side there, and now we can use it. You can also find this tool in your command manager using Shift C, and then you can search for it, Flatten. And you can see that we are using the mesh tool and not the node operator. They have similar icons, but for right now, we're just talking about the mesh version of this. So you could, in theory, drag and drop this anywhere you want as well. You can save this to your UI if you want to up here. save layout as. For right now, I'm just going to move on and we're going to talk about the flatten tool. So I'll click this here. If I click and drag my mouse to the right, we are increasing the strength of this tool, as you can see in the attribute manager. This is it at 100%. If I move my mouse to the left, it takes it down to zero. We can also affect the position by clicking and dragging our mouse while holding the shift button. So if I hold shift, actually first I want to bring up the strength all the way. So I'll do this and build up that strength, and then I'll hit shift and now we'll move it again, and you can see it's adjusting the position. So if you move it to the left, we're moving the selection to the left in terms of position. If we move our mouse to the right while holding shift, it is adjusting the strength outwards. So that is that option there. We have individual polygons selected right now, so it is calculating flattening out these surfaces using these areas as separate entities. If you turn this off, it will calculate that, treating these areas as one instead of separate islands. So you can see that they're all flattened along the same plane when we turn off individual islands. I'm going to keep individual islands on. We have this other option here called outline only. If you select outline only, it will only use the circumference of your selections in order to calculate how these are being flattened. And we're going to talk a little bit about the different modes and the different ways Cinema 4D can calculate how these areas are being flattened, because you actually have quite a bit of control over that. I'm going to leave outline only off right now, and if we leave that off, we'll be using everything that's selected in order to calculate how this is being flattened and the plane in which it's being flattened. So right now we have our mode set to best fit, and that is the default option. This uses all the points and their positions in order to calculate how this will be flattened out. In a sense, it's almost averaging all those positions in order to create this flattened plane so that you can have this flattened surface. That's your first option. Our next option is view. It'll use the camera view and it will make those surfaces flattened parallel to the camera view. So if I actually move around my camera now, you can see that those are all oriented towards where my camera was at initially when I selected that mode. If I hit the middle mouse button, you'll see we can use the right mode, the front, the right view, the front view, and the top view in order to control which direction this is being flattened if you want to use the mode view. You can also adjust which camera is being used up here. You could choose bottom, back, front, right, left. You have options here in terms of your camera orientation. So if you want to use view and your camera orientation in order to flatten these surfaces, you can, and that's the way to do it. I'll click the middle mouse button again on perspective, and we'll go into our next option. The next option is normal, and we've talked quite a bit about normals and what they are. So if you want to learn more about normals, I will leave a link about normals and the episode on that in the description below. But for right now, just to describe what this does, it will take all the normals of what you have selected, and it will use those in order to take the average of all those normal directions. And in doing so, it will create a plane, and it will use that plane in order to know how, which direction these are being flattened. So this is how that works, and it looks very similar to best fit. It's just a slight variation, and you can see if I switch between these two. You don't really need to understand the difference between normal and best fit that much as an artist. You just need to know how to get your model to look the way you'd like it to. And you can try out these different options. They're very similar. Modeling axis, it will use the model's axis in order to decide what plane these are being flattened on. So if I click modeling axis, you'll see we have some different options here. Right now we have Z selected. So notice these are flattened in the Z direction of our model. You can see this is the Z up here, but this is using the modeling axis. So even if we were to hit undo, go into model mode and rotate this some, and then we go back and click on this and go back into polygon mode, use flatten again, choosing Z, and we were to flatten this, you'll notice that it's not using the world axis in order to flatten this, it's using the model's axis. So it's the Z direction of the model. You can choose Y, you can use X. It's all up to you. But that is how it's determining what plane this is being flattened on. Now you also have the world axis. And you'll see it's using the axes you can see up here. And those are your world axes. And that's the position of your grid. So you have X, Y, and Z again as your options. There's a setting unique to modeling axis and world axis modes. So I'd like to show that to you real quick. You'll see this option called Use Axis Position. And if you were to select that, you'll see this just moved a little bit. When you have Use Axis Position on, it will use the position of the axis rather than the average of the position of what's selected in order to decide where this flattened plane is going. If we turn this off, it uses the average of what's selected for that position. And you can adjust this using this here. So you have those two options. So actually, we've gone through all of the options for this tool. And it's a really simple, straightforward tool to use. And it's really helpful for if you're 3D modeling anything with a flat surface. Think of mechanical, robotic kinds of structures. Maybe some furniture, if you're 3D modeling a couch and you need part of that couch to be flat while the other part needs to be curved, it's a great tool. You can use it on anything that you need there to be a flat surface. This is a great option. And I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you did, please hit like and subscribe so you'll be notified when another 3D modeling tutorial like this comes out. And I hope to see you again next week on ambient 3D animations. So thank you so much for watching.